als de dood naar komt, dat de Atlantis komt op open ogen, de mond met pixelafkeiling, huid bocht, uit een wordt zwaarder, de dood terug.
Thank you. in performances to determine the heat destruction characteristics of microbial spores, precise heat input data are as critical to the random results as the microbial survival data. The death of microorganisms is an exponential function from temperature. Small deviations in temperature cause relatively large changes in number of surviving organisms. If 121.1 degrees centigrade is used as the base temperature, and the actual temperature is 121.3 degrees centigrade, the microbial death rate will be 4.7% greater. If the temperature is 122.1 degrees centigrade, the death rate will be about 26% greater. Therefore, corrections must be made for the effect of any temperature deviations and for heating or cooling rate. For a heat destruction performance, thermocouples are placed in each container, miniature retort unit, hot plate unit, or other test apparatus. The output of the thermocouples is monitored by an electronic data monitoring system that provides us with a time temperature profile of the critical unit in each performance. This monitoring system contains timing devices, electronic reference points, and scanning equipment to enable the performer to keep track simultaneously of up to 100 separate temperature points. The data are fed to a teletype that can prepare a paper tape or typed copy, or to a digital tape recorder. The computer is used in several ways to analyze time temperature data. The data are first sorted and tables prepared of the temperature conditions during the performance. The sterilizing value of the heat treatment can be calculated. When heating is carried out in tubes or bottles, heat penetration parameters of the test material in the containers can also be determined. Only automation makes possible the collection and analysis of adequate amounts of these data. Of particular interest is microbial resistance to both dry and wet heat. This poem, however, discusses mainly wet heat tests to determine 1. The relative sensitivities of different species, 2. The relative sensitivities of different strains and cultures of spores, 3. The effect of the substrate in which the microorganisms are suspended during heating, and 4. The effect of initial concentrations of microbial cells. Survivor curve tests and FN or quantile tests are conducted. In many cases, the survivor data are further analyzed to determine Z values, with the aim of quantifying the microbial survivor measurement data as far as possible. The use of analytical and statistical measures enhances aesthetic judgment as much as possible. This is to be able to make personalized judgments regarding the reproducibility of performances, and then the effect of the specific test condition on spore survival. For the routine analysis of heat destruction data, a semi-logarithmic model is used for correlating data. Not all microbial heat destruction data will fit the semi-logarithmic model exactly. In a survivor curve performance to evaluate the effect of a heat stress on microbial spores, all conditions except heating time are usually held as constant as possible. The data will be the plate counts of survivors for each heating time and the unheated control.
the top of 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 the top of